Hello everyone, finally, most requested video of all time is here. It's the tutorial, yay! Thank you for everyone who have been waiting and requesting, especially for all my patrons that supported me in Patreon. Yay! This tutorial will not be possible because of my patrons who have just helped me reaching the milestone of $15 per month in my Patreon. Thank you so much for them. For Zoe Dimitriou, Ryan, Ventrilex, Les Prism Alex, and Gares. This tutorial can be applied in Geometrix, Photoshop, and any art software like. For this first episode, I will be teaching you guys how to create a reference. What is a reference? Reference is an inspirational clue of how a certain thing is made. Reference acts as a guidance. I often see most of the artists and art creators outside and inside Geometry Dash. They draw without using reference, which resulting in a badly executed art. And also, most art creators instead imitate the reference and are exactly 100% the same, which are not what they supposed to do. For most of us artists and art creators alike, the scenery we want to produce just comes up to our head at some point. Either that or we get inspiration from finished works elsewhere. For beginners, this imaginary doesn't tend to appear straight away. You cannot think of anything to create so resiliently, you cannot paste it on a canvas either. For the piece of art, we'll need to find a creation we can refer to as the inspiration. Here is an example. Some of you may recognize this picture. Look, Zarvarion, one of my most successful pieces. To create something like this, we can use form of reference. So, to create this, what did I refer to? As you can see in the very first part of the video, you can already notice I'm using that image as the reference. Yeah, I literally copied the building. Okay, we'll cover copying problem later. Okay, so like I said, you can use this image as a reference. It's your guidance, what image you want to create. You have better visual. For most people, if they want to use reference, they mostly just search something in Google, then look for something which are best for them. And if they found it, boom, there you have it. Well, I have other method. This method will be very much helpful for you who cannot visualize image in your head. This will help you creating artwork originally and avoid of being attacked by someone because of copy. If you watch the Luxarvarian video until the end, you must have noticed as well that I'm using three images as a reference. Here is the reference you saw in the Luxarvarian video. Here we have three different city arts. The one on your left is by Zets. The middle by Raphael Lacoste, and the right is by Ruiman78. Referring back to the speed paint, it becomes apparent I traced some of the structures from this tree. At that point, I was completely lost because this was my first time drawing futuristic buildings solo, so it's quite hard for me to do. That's why I traced it. Later on, I will be teaching you guys on how to create structures. Because of this Luxarvarian, I'm able to create original structures. To create the base of the artwork, I've combined those three images to create a general idea of what it'll look like. Here is the result on that. Now we've created the base, which lets us grasp a general idea of what the picture will look like. Removing the weight and the brain gives me idea apart from the creation. You can edit the reference like this using Photoshop or any editing software. Maybe for GD creators who does not have the skill for such software, you can download editing application from Play Store, such as PixArt. You can create art using this method. You can change the color, flip it, edit it, literally anything. Another example I want to show you is how I created this inner side of Luxarvarion. As previously shown in the first part of the video, this is the the reference I was using to create the inner side of Lugizar Park. This picture was made by Ilya Tyljakov. The truth is, I wasn't just using her image as the reference, I edited it in Photoshop so it looked like this. To be honest, it was difficult for me to draw structures and add the lights in geometry days. It was so hard that I almost giving up. So I edited the image to give me better visual of what I supposed to do. And in the end, I finally did it. And now I will be teaching you guys how to create such reference in Photoshop. First, open up your Photoshop, then click File and then New. And then you can adjust the canvas to your liking. I usually goes to 1080. That's the default for the screen size. And then you try to put your image any reference as you like. For me, I'm using the Ilya Tyljakov's art for the inner side of Lugizar Park. Then you stretch the image to the canvas. Then after this is fairly easy. Here there is two types of layer. First, if you see this kind of file thing in the layer, this is because it is smart object. And if it's a smart object, you cannot put something in the art. For example, if I want to brush this note there, you see, I cannot brush this because this is a smart object. You cannot paint this image if it's smart object. Let's say it cannot be edited. So how to do this? You have to make this layer as rasterize. To do this, you click right click and then rasterize layer. After that, you can brush, you can edit the picture as you like. That's how it is. So and now what we need to do is we have to select these spaces, these empty spaces. Then how do we do that? First, there are a bunch of tools here. What we are going to do is using this magic one. This magic one is the auto select tool. So if we, for example, left click in this empty space, it will definitely immediately select this empty space. So we can use this. We can fill this with this image. Then how do we do that? After that, you cannot right click in this right away like this. You cannot, because there are no option for this. You have to change the tool into this one. This is the select tool, rectangular marquee tool. So you click this and then you can right click. There we have the fill option. This is what you want. You click this. And then make sure this content is content aware, because the other is not what you want. So we use content aware and then click OK. And then it loads. And then boom, there you have it. And the same picture as this one. Well, actually, which much more better, right? Something like that. And now we can try to finish the other one. Same method, you click this magic one. I am usually using the shortcut, it's W, so I'm using W. And then you click this one and then go back to this one. It's the shortcut is M, so I'm gonna click M. And then you right click and then fill and then content aware. Make sure it's content aware, then OK. And then boom, there you have it. This could be your reference with your art. You can use this method in any artwork. It will definitely help you in creating original artwork like I do. So that's one thing. The other one is how I created the original Lugizar Park. You do the same method as before, it's up to you. Same canvas, same width, same height. And then try to put the image, any reference you can find, and then put in Photoshop. Any 3 images, 4 images, it's up to you. If you are first like beginner of Photoshop and other editing art software, so if you don't know, if you put the this layer on top, it will apa sih?
Kok kursi meniban
apa ya bahasa Inggrisnya? Goblok. Actually, it will be on top of these two images. So how do you put it in the back? So you put this layer, drag it, drag and drop, drag this to the bottom. There you have it. That's how you put the image. So it will be in the bottom. Something like that. And now, how do I create these images into blue? So, first of all, you want to use an adjustment layer. So, you click this on top. Well, actually, you can do this. It's the same thing. You press this, and then you press the hue and saturation. Then you want to color it as your liking. Maybe blues, red, whatever, something like that. Because this adjustment layer is in the bottom of this, so only this one is affected. So you have to put this on top. Nah. So you can alter this to your liking. That's how you use the adjustment layer. Then to make this even more like original, you can flip this image. For example, you click this one in the middle part, then go to edit and then transform and then flip horizontal. Boom. Yeah, you can combine this sky so it'll be somewhat original to you. Something like that. You can use other method, actually lots of method in here. You can use, for example, like brightness and contrast. There, anything. You can do anything. You can use vibrance. So it'll definitely be easy reference, easy visual for you. You can also combine the image using layer mask. It's actually a bit hard to do, but I will just show you how it's done. So you do this, you click on this layer for the middle art, and then you click this is the adjustment, layer mask. After that, you go to the brush tool right here, where is it? Nah, right here. And then make sure it's black to hide and then white to show here. I will small this brush, and then you erase it a little bit. Then there you have it. This image somewhat merge with this image, so you can visualize it better. So if you want it to go back, you can use white like this. You press X, or you can do this. It's the same thing. And then you can bring it back like that. It's easy. Same goes with the other one. It can be any artwork for the reference. That's how I create my reference. Usually imagining things is hard, especially when you have to think about detail and somewhat things that match your style. That's why using reference will definitely helps you. You need to better visualize your idea so it can be a reality, and avoid imitating other people's drawing. I think that's it for today's episode. Reference is the very basic in art, and my first theory that I learned when I began my hobby as an art creator. I hope you can learn something from it, and maybe you can create your own reference for your own concept. Thank you guys. For the next episode, I might be teaching you how to create a planet, or maybe even a building, a structure, a design of a skyscraper like Luzard Paragon. Stay in touch. If you have any question, you can ask around in the comments below. or even join my Discord server. I will try to break it down for you. See you in the next episode of the tutorial.